Welcome to another FL Studio video. Today we are looking at the FL Studio patcher, and I will show you how to route multiple MIDI channels into a Kontakt instrument within the patcher, and then we will make use of the multiple outputs of a Kontakt instrument. My name is Mattias, and let's take the tour. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like, and write some nice feedback in the comment section so that I can make more nice music production and sound design videos for you. Thanks! Yeah, so here we are in FL Studio 20, and generally we only have about 125 tracks within the mixer to work with. That might or might not be enough for your specific productions. If you're doing tons of orchestral arrangements, you probably might need more if you want to have these really big, huge templates. And one way to set this up is by using the patcher and loading up multi-timbral instruments within the patcher. So let's begin here by pressing the plus sign in our channel rack and adding the patcher. And within the patcher, we can go in here and right-click on this node, the event node here, and insert a Kontakt 64-bit plugin. If you want to learn more about the patcher, I have several videos on FL Studio patcher, so you can click the cards up here or look in the description for those videos. Okay, so we have our Kontakt instrument loaded here, and let's go in here by double clicking on the Kontakt, and let's just load up maybe some Albion patches here, which is a orchestral library. We can load up some short pizzicato strings, pizzicato, and we will route this instrument to channel 5. Great, so we have one instrument loaded. Now we can load up a second instrument, and we will load some woodwinds arranged short. And as we can see here, we have MIDI channel 1 for the strings and MIDI channel 2 for these woodwinds. And we also need to set a separate stereo output pair for this for the woodwinds here. Yeah, and now we need to go to the outputs to add some more outputs here. So we go up to this screen and select the outputs, and that will show us this auxiliary output section. So we just press the plus sign here and add two extra channels, and they will be attached to aux 1. Okay, so now we have an extra stereo pair here called stereo 2. So we can send this woodwinds high to the stereo 2. So now we have two channels set up here within Kontakt. So let's go back and close that down. So we go to the patcher again, and we can right click on the Kontakt instrument here in the patcher and select outputs, audio, and you can see that we only have the main output activated. So we need to activate, we can activate all. And we also need to go in here to the Kontakt instrument, go up to the wrench icon here, or the cog wheel, which is for the settings. And here we can set the MIDI input port. So we want to have different MIDI channels here in our channel rack to be able to send multi-timbral different channels to this single patcher. So we'll set the input port to, say, yeah, we can set it to 0. Then we need to go to the processing to AUTOMAP these stereo outputs. Press AUTOMAP, and that will automatically map up our outputs. So now we have our first stereo pair from Kontakt being sent through this little cable. Then we have this second one. You can look up here and see and get the name for the output. So we have the main output, then we have send 1. So if we say we add a reverb in here to in the patcher, you can add a Valhalla room for the sake of it. And just detach this cable and drag the first one to the reverb. Now you can hear we have tons of reverb on this string patch. And now we can add a second effect here, a delay. Let's go here and look up Fruity Delay 3. And now we route this second channel to our delay and continuously to the FL Studio mixer. Okay, so now we need to set up this second instrument, which is the woodwind. We need to get the MIDI into this instrument. So we add two new channels to our channel rack, and we add the MIDI out, and we set the port to 0, and this is channel 1. You can also set up MIDI CC for these different knobs if you want to send the MIDI CCs. So you can say MIDI CC1, mod wheel. And now you will have mod wheel being sent to that channel 1 instrument within this patcher contact, this contact instance. Then we add a second MIDI out and make sure that this one is sending to MIDI channel 2 on port 0. Now both of these tracks will be sending to this patcher instrument. Okay, another crucial step here within the patcher is that you need to set up this input port in the FL Studio input for your patcher. So you right click on this device, go to outputs, events, and make it receive from port 0, which is the port that we set to receive on. So by hovering on these nodes, we can look up in the left corner or the information panel and see that this one is our MIDI port 0. And then we drag the MIDI port 0 to our contact instrument. And now we should be able to play these instruments. So that's tons of too much reverb, but let's just drag it down slightly. Like that. And let's see if we can select this second MIDI output, which should be the flutes. With this really long delay. So now we have effectively set up a multi-timbral contact instrument within the patcher, and now we can add all kinds of processing here, and we can exclude this 125 track limit, as we can have as many instruments as we want or as many as the CPU can handle within this patcher environment. So we could add some, maybe some extra processing here behind the delay. We could add a plugin, maybe add a this love filter. Okay, so in conclusion, you can see it's a quite fiddly setup to do this in FL Studio, but as long as you set this up, you can just copy this patcher and replace the contact instruments within that second patcher instance. So you could have one patcher for your strings, one patcher for your brass instruments and woodwinds, percussion, etc. So it's a quite powerful setup and you're not restricted by the 125 channels mixer in FL Studio. I hope you liked this video. If you have any questions, please write them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching today. My name is Mattias and see you in the next video. Bye.